Hello friends, I'm Chef Umesh from Chitkara School of Hospitality, and today we will learn about stocks. The objective of today's chapter is to know about what is a stock, the ingredients that are used to make a stock, different types of stock, their uses, and some guidelines to produce a good stock. We already know that a stock is a flavorful liquid which is made up of meat, meat bones, fish bones, veal bones, or sometimes vegetable trimmings, which are cooked for prolonged period to extract the flavor. The exceptional is fish stock, which is only cooked for 20 minutes to 25 minutes. These stocks are also known as found de cuisine because, as we already know, that to climb a ladder we need to take the first step, or to prepare a foundation. Similarly, to prepare a good soup or sauce, we need to prepare a foundation liquid, which is known as stock. Stocks basically are divided into four categories, known as white stock, which is fond du blanc, brown stock, fond brun, vegetable or neutral stock, which is fond maigre, and fish stock, fumé de poisson. The classification refers to the contents and method used to prepare the stock, not necessarily their color. White stock is made with white meat or beef, veal bones, chicken, and aromatic vegetables, in which the bones or meat are put into cold liquid and slowly brought to a boil. The mirepoix, which is a flavoring base of diced vegetable, are sweated in suitable fat and then added to the liquid before it develops any color. The mixture is then reduced to a simmer to finish cooking. This stock is used for preparing white sauce, blanket, fricasse, and post dishes. Then brown stock, which is also known as astufad. It is made up of beef, veal, and poultry, and other bones. The bones are first roasted until they are golden in color, but not burnt, because you already know that burnt bones and burnt mirepoix will damage the stock's flavor and color both. The mirepoix is then added when the bones are 3/4 roasted. Tomato products like puree or paste may also be added. When the bones and mirepoix are golden in color, cold liquid is added and the mixture is slowly brought to a boil. And then it is reduced to a simmer to finish cooking. This stock is used to make brown sauce, gravies, braised dishes, and meat glazes. Another stock is vegetable stock, which is also known as neutral stock, which is composed of vegetable and aromatic herbs sauteed gently in butter, then cooked in liquid. The last but not the least classification is fish stock, which is fumé de poisson, is categorized separately from other three stocks because of its limited usage. The basis of fish preparation is the fumé or fond. It has been said that all fish produce a fumé are equal. Some fish produce better quality stock than others. The result from some fish are stocks which are too gelatinous and fishy tasting. Fish are which contain oil may yield oily stock or make the stock bitter in taste. Classical preparation of fish stock calls up for bones of specific fish for fumé, like Dover sole, turbo, brill, and whiting are recommended for making superior kind of stocks or provide superior flavor. However, the important thing is that the fish is fresh and its flesh is white. There are few guidelines while preparing fish fumé or fumé de poisson. Those are: never use trimmings from oily fish such as salmon, mackerel, bluefish, etc. Flounder or lemon sole kind of fish will work for sole fumé, halibut for turbo, and strip bass for brill. The freshest ingredients are always required to prepare anything. Sometimes the complementary juices of oyster, mussel or clam are added to fish fumé to give or impart their flavor. In our next slide, we will read about components or ingredients that go in a stock. Starting from bones, veal, beef, chicken bones are most commonly used. The flavor of the stock comes from the cartilage and connective tissue in the bones. Connective tissue has collagen in it, which gets converted into gelatin that thickens the liquid. Stock made from bones needs to be simmered for longer than stock made from meat, other referred to as broth, which we will read in our next chapter. Bone should be cut into 3-inch lengths for quicker and more thorough extraction of flavor, gelatin and nutritive value. Then comes vegetable or mayapua. Vegetable can be used in form of mayapua, white mayapua and metigno. Mayapua is a combination of onions, carrot, celery and sometimes other vegetable. Often the less desirable parts of vegetables such as carrot skins, celery ends are used since they will not be eaten. White mayapua replaces carrots with parsnip in it, additional onions and leeks, and occasionally include chopped mushroom or mushroom trimmings. It is used for pale or white stock or sauces. Metigno are the edible part of vegetable, or can be said is an edible mayapua intended to be served as part of the finished dish. The vegetables are peeled and cut into uniform dices. Then liquid or water is the most frequently used liquid for making a stock. Remoulade, which is also known as second stock, is the best choice for the most richly flavored stock. Wine may also be used. The liquid should be cold when combined with the bones and vegetables. Herbs and spices, or bouquet garni or shashadi pies, are used as per their availability and the traditional usage. In classical cuisine, the use of bouquet garni or bundle of herbs consisting of parsley, bay leaves, sprig of thyme, possibly other herbs also, are common. This is often wrapped in a cheesecloth or bag and tied with strings to make it easier to remove it once the stock is cooked. Then uses of stock are limited, but different dishes can be prepared from it. For example, stocks are used as base for sauces and soups. They are also used for stews and braising purposes, as a cooking medium for vegetables and grains, and they are also used to prepare glaze and aspic. There are certain guidelines when we prepare stocks. They are: starting from cold water, cover the ingredients with clean cold water. Starting in this manner allows the blood and proteins to dissolve. As the temperature rises, the proteins coagulate and solidify, and then they start floating to the surface where they can be skimmed off. If they were started in hot water, the proteins would solidify, stick to the bones, and then disperse into the stock, making it cloudy and muddy in taste. Simmer the stock gently, never boil it. A stock should be brought to a boil and then immediately reduced to a simmer. At a simmer, the ingredients release the maximum flavor without breaking down into particulate matter. If a stock boils for even a few minutes, the fat will emulsify into the stock and the stock will become cloudy, making it poor or giving it a muddy taste. Keep skimming it frequently to avoid clouding of the stock. Strain it carefully. This involves a china cap or a chinois set inside of a strainer. In order to use the stock, you must separate the solids from the liquid. While doing so, it is important not to disturb the solids in the bottom of the pot. Then always cool it quickly once prepared and store it in the frozen state. Always use a tall, narrow pot to minimize evaporation, because a stock requires to be cooked for a longer duration. Then coming to evaluating quality of stocks. A good stock is evaluated by its flavor, color, aroma and clarity. If we talk about flavor, the correct procedure and ratio of the bones, mayapua and aromatic to the liquids has been followed. The flavor should be well balanced, rich and full bodied. Color: white stocks and fish fumet should have a very light color that turns translucent. Brown stocks are a deep amber or brown because of the roasting process. Aroma: the aroma should be appealing but not over pungent. When a stock is reboiled, it should be tested for sour taste and smell. Clarity: is one of the most important part that needs to be checked in a stock. Most stock, with the exception of vegetable essence and fish fumet, should be almost crystal clear when hot. This is maintained by proper simmering. Never allow the stock to boil continuously, and also skim the stock during the cooking process, which is also known as depoiler. Skimming removes the impurities that are trapped by the coagulated albumin that rises to the top during the cooking process. Then there are some faults in stock production. What would I do if my stock gets cloudy? I must have done something wrong, like I have used incorrect ingredients and prepared it poorly. I boiled my stock, incorrect cooking method, stock was not skimmed properly, or I used an old stock. Oh no, my stock lacks flavor. So it might be the reason could be incorrect ratio of ingredients to liquid, and cooking time was too short. Then there are certain care and precautions while making a stock, which are: always use good quality of bones, always start with cold water, do not use oily fish for fish stock because it will make your stock dull and fat oily. Always saute fish bones with marcua in very little amount of butter. Excess butter will result in an oily stock. Blanch the bones and then make the stock for better results. Never ever season your stock because it is going to be used for making soup and sauces, in which seasoning will be balanced late in the later stages. Never boil a stock, skim regularly, never ever stir the stock. While stirring makes it cloudy. Do not use potatoes, swede, turnips, etc. as marcua vegetables because these all have starch and they make your stock cloudy. Always reboil stocks. It is quite important. Now there are some certain culinary terms associated with stock. For example, bouquet garni. It is a bundle of herbs and aromatics tied within sections of leek with cooking twine, which is a thread, and simmered in stock to add flavor and aroma. We can also add celery, fresh thyme, parsley, stems and bay leaves. Shashadi spices, a small cheese cloth sack containing herbs and spices used to flavor stocks, translate literally to a bag of spices. Then there is marpua. If we talk about standard and white, standard marpua contains roughly cut vegetables like onions, carrots and celery in the ratio of 50:25:25 respectively. In white marpua, red vegetables are changed with marpua onion, celery, leeks and turnips. Other term is depoiler, which is also translated as depouiller. This term signifies the process of skimming a stock for the first time while it is simmering. Deglazing, a technique by which liquid is poured into the pan and heated, stirred with a wooden spoon to remove the caramelized residue after roasting the meats and vegetables, and then adding the floating residue to the simmering stock. Broth and bouillons are the flavoring liquid obtained by simmering meats and vegetables together. Consommé are the clarified clear stocks or broth, which are clarified with the help of egg whites, mincemeat, and then simmered. Aspic, when a consommé is reduced by 30%, this reduction effectively increases its gelatin content and flavor. Combined with a white wine such as Madeira, Port, or Sherry, consommé gets converted into aspic. Aspic is used to coat individually served foods such as pâté, poached eggs, cold cuts, etc. Then glazes, essence, remoulade, celery, essence, these are certain terms which we will read in our next slide. Ending it now. Thank you for attending this session. For any queries, you may reach out to me at umesh.chukran@chitkara.edu.in. Thank you.